Before 2004, our city of Tagum faced the problem on disorganized arrangement of ambulance vendors doing business on nighttime. Alongside with this, the problems on garbage disposal and peace and order within downtown area where these vendors operate also challenged our local government to come up with a win-win solution. Thus, the night market program was established. Formalized through the enactment of a night market ordinance, the city government strategically arranged the vendors in the roads by sectioning busy streets during daytime, were transformed into a bustling economic scene during nighttime. With only 80 plus vendors in 2004, the number of vendors operating in our night market is now at 317 and employs a total of 1,268 individuals, most of whom are unemployed parents and working students. And we operate 7 nights a week compared to other local government units, which only operate over the weekend. With only 1,000 pesos net income per night in 2003, our vendors are more than happy and satisfied with their nightly net income ranging from 1,200 pesos to 6,000 pesos. This huge amount enables them to help their families and workers. The night market is composed of one supervisor and 3 collectors. There is also one sanitary inspector from the city health office. The collection of the payments is done nightly by 3 collectors, after which they report to the office and file their collection and deposit and the abstract of collection before 11 in the morning. After a thorough checking by the revenue collection officer and the accountable forms officer, the payments are then remitted to the City Economic Enterprises Office cashier. And the records are kept by the CEO bookkeeper. By 1 o'clock in the afternoon daily, all collections are already deposited at the separate special account of the economic enterprises. The deposit slip and the report shall then be submitted to the city treasurer's office. We incorporated night market under the cultural trade center of our city economic enterprises office. From 379,712 pesos in 2004, the annual income of the night market hiked to 6,670,161 pesos in 2013. This is equivalent to a 1,757% increase. In 2013 alone, the night market contributed 42% to the annual income of the Trade and Cultural Center. In turn, the Trade and Cultural Center contributed 18% to the total annual income of the economic enterprises, amounting to more than 87 million pesos. The only capital poured by the LGU is the closure of roads and more than 500,000 pesos annually for the salaries of 1 supervisor and 3 collectors. It has imagine investing cash of 500,000 and gain about more than 6 million pesos. The success of the night market program is attributed to effective and efficient management by the City Economic Enterprises Office, which is a separate department under our local bureaucracy. Our vendors say this is just their little contribution to the city's development. We reciprocate this attitude by helping them achieve more in their business undertaking. As such, we infuse literacy programs following the idea that we just don't collect taxes from them, but we also help them succeed. In 2011, we were recognized by the UNESCO for our peace management literacy and continuing education through the Night Market Program, our first international award. Other innovation in this program are the nightly operation, which is unique in Tagum, products and goods sectioning, hygiene and sanitation, the participation of security volunteers, and legislation. The night market of Tagum celebrates its 10th anniversary this coming October 2014. The sustainability of this economic enterprises program by the LGU is anchored on the enactment of City Ordinance No. 161 passed 10 years ago. With this important piece of legislation, the sustainability of the program is ensured and the replication by other local government units will be made easier. In fact, yung Davao City po, kay Mayor Duterte, okay-okay lang nagsimula siya and they started. They would like to pattern our city style of having it Monday to Sunday. And malay-palay, soon that we will be submitting sisterhood, meron silang night cafe 3 times a week. The night market success is also attributed to the night market vendors themselves. residents. They are our partners.
The management of our program. They help us in maintaining cleanliness and orderliness in the night market. In maintaining peace and order, our LGU paid security management officers get help from the various force multipliers groups like the Caranso, the Motorcycle Riders Group, and the Urgent, the Communication Group. This program develops a sense of volunteerism fueled by community ownership.
With this, we consider the night market program as Tagumpay.
What will make this galing walkable, since there are many night markets that are going on throughout the country? But I was wondering whether there are adverse social impacts of the night market. If there is child labor in the night market, if there is, how do you address this? What is the role of your barangays in the management of the night market?
For more than 10 years na, wala pong reported cases about yung mga nangyayari po. For minor, bawat vendor po ay niregister namin, kahit ambulant lang yan. We also require them to submit the name, information of the workers. Yun po ang pagbabasihan. May ID po na issuances namin through occupational ID.
I have already signed
another executive order reconstituting the Economic Enterprises Regulatory Board. This is a multi-sectoral where the Vendors Association is represented in that board.
The location is so strategic. It's in the center, the heart of the city, the trade center. And in the perimeter, it's temporarily we close. We have the security management officers alongside with these volunteers. The barangay has also its share in monitoring because they have also a stake on that. Because the garbage that can be collected will be deposited to the MRF of the barangay and you will earn. May mga barangay tanong po at kasama.
Ano ang naging epekto sa mga regular business establishment in that area?
Wala naman po. They complement each other kasi most yung maiiwan yung mga parlors, pharmacy. Yung economic activity ay hindi po in competition with them because at 5 o'clock, doon na sila. Most of those in the sides, nagsasara na po at the 5. May iba naman, they say because ang line of business yung malapit sa kanila ay hindi kapareho. More than 10 years na wala namang nagre-reklamo.
Anong diferensya noon at nung nagtayo na ng night market? Bakit biglang lumaki ang income ninyo?
Ang time namin noon is medyo maaga-aga pa konti, alas 3 hanggang alas 8 ng gabi. Nang pumasa na ang night market ordinance, doon na nag-iba dahil binigyan na kami ng malaking area. Tapos yung kalsada na dinadaanan noon na-close na, doon na kami nilagay. Nakapaglagay na kami ng maraming lamisa sa gitna ng kalsada. Doon lumaki ang binta namin.
Nagbabayad ba kayo sa local government?
Nung dati po sir, nagbabayad kami. Cash ticket namin is 5 pesos lang per day, per night.
Ngayon, magkano na?
Ngayon is 380 yung para sa akin lang po.
Hindi nyo ba ho naiisip in terms of sustaining the economic development ng ating mga stall owners ay magtayo na lang ng talagang isang lugar na kung saan parang common facility na pwede sila, yung sa Singapore, no, yung meron silang lugar doon na kainan, maraming mga ano, iba't ibang stall.
We will take note of that. May dalawang creek po kami na nilagyan namin ng daan and that would be another area for the okay-okay. So we will be transferring the okay-okay. Ginawa namin yung dalawang creek kasi doon. So that ang maiwan doon yung sa food. So meron pa kami space for expansion.
Brought to you by PhilPost.